And by default, in this particular thing, symmetry is on. So let's we're going to block out. So let's blocking is basically blocking the basic volume and shape. It's nothing to do with detailing. So BMB. So first thing process, like you can see, it's pretty dense. Elongate the head.
It will be like egg shape, sir, in head.
Head, yes. Head is not round. Head is egg shape. Head is never round. So basic, if you remember that book I initially asked and shared.
Yes.
If you check the book, head is never round. So initially we'll take the basic shape. It's circular, but it's not round. So for front, I'll just pull it down. I'm using skin shader. You can use normal gray material also. That's fine. Nothing fancy. Just pull it down. That's it. And from back, pull it slightly backside, slightly up, slightly down. So front, you can see front and side. So basically two egg shape, right? If you simplify it, this is one egg shape and this is one egg shape. And from backside, broaden it up slightly. Basics, this is our basic structure of head. If you want to like double check, open the book, it will be like easy for you to reference. And this is a very good book for like learning and practicing and for any kind of muscle body structure. It's a very good book. Like in a long, very, very, very long time, I have seen something like this is like really productive and it works. And this is targeted towards 3D artists. So you can see all the muscle flow, line flow, and the structure. So they have simplified everything very nicely. It's here. So here you can see our skull. And now you can see head shape. Here you can see this is the basic fundamentals of head. Egg shape, then a cylinder, another cylinder. So you can see slightly broader at the back. It's not round and narrow from the front. So like simplify, yes, if you want, you can use three different parts and then dynamic and create it, or you can just simply pull it and create the basic structure. Both works. So idea is to create a basic structure. So when you while you're blocking out, make sure your perspective is off. So blocking time, no perspective. Once your blocking is done, then we'll switch on blocking. Then switch on perspective. Okay.
What is the problem, sir? If it is enable perspective,
Your model will be distorted. Proportion will be wrong.
Okay.
Because if you create any model in perspective initial state only, it will look entirely different after finishing. If you switch on this thing, you see it becomes slightly narrow, right? So blocking becomes a little difficult. So blocking time, no perspective at all. After blocking it out, then we switch on perspective and fix everything.
If it is not enabled, also no problem, right, sir? After.
No. Once your blocking is done, you have to switch out perspective because that is your final output.
Okay. Right?
So after blocking everything, then you have to switch on your perspective. Otherwise, your proportion will be way off.
Okay.
So that's how it works. You can like once you start practicing and working like this, you'll see the difference. Like what is the like what because when you create something in perspective and then you switch off perspective. It will look really odd, and when you switch off, like create something in without perspective entirely, like full detail, and then you switch in perspective, it will look entirely different, and it will look little squeeze a little odd. So that's why we move between perspective and orthographic, both the views, and cross check and make sure everything works perfectly.
Okay.
So egg shape. So basic egg shape is ready. And now I have to like block out my basic shapes and everything. So The easiest way that I personally follow is, so my this thing, I'll make it slightly more straightish, slightly more straight. Like I said, it's pretty narrow. So initial blocking is two eggs, but our head is exactly not like that. Our head shape is way complex than that. So now I'm just simply base shape. Now let's see, B, C, B, down, use the brush size. I can use BCB, I can use Trim Dynamics, just flatten this surface. The reason why we're doing flattening this area, the once you flatten it, you'll see the jawline. Otherwise, this jawline, it won't be visible. So you have to manually fix and do things. This part also you can see it should become till here. So I did it too much. With some till here I have to do. Slightly soften. So at this stage, soften the don't soften doesn't matter. So this thing ends here. So wherever your skull ends, your neck starts from there. You can see this roundness here and neck starts, right?
Yeah.
That thing you have to keep in your mind. Now, wherever it ends, just next to that, we'll mask it, invert it, and pull it slightly back. So it's always in slightly angle, it never straight. It never straight, it's slightly in like the angle around 40, 45 degree angle, always. So this is how our normal human structure is. If you see yourself in mirror, and best practice is whenever you create a humanoid character, refer your own body, own proportion. Check your, see yourself in mirror, right? So you can see your neck is always slightly front. It's not straight until unless you have some kind of medical condition. So no, naturally our head is slight, neck is slightly tilted, right? So those small things makes a lot of difference. So once you do this, control drag outside, it will redynamize the model. That is something we all know, we know already. So redynamize the model. You can see I got the neck structure. Now let's block out the face, base body, and all these things will do. So let's see. So sorry, my bad. BCB clay build up. So first thing, now we need to generate all this jawline, our cheekbones, nose, eyes, and all those things we have to do. So for eyes, personally, what I prefer, I just push it inside first, like this. Push it inside. Reason, you have a nose bridge here, nose hole, and you have eye cavity. So if you create this gap first, then it becomes super easy. So this gap, create the gap first, and this, okay. One more thing, this gap, where to create this gap? It's almost the halfway of the skull. Halfway. That's our basic proportion of head. You can see this thing. You can see it's a box and center. Halfway, you have eyes. So this is basic proportion and this is fundamentals. If you don't understand or don't know this, it will be a huge problem. Because basic fundamental, your eye, if you take chin to forehead, your head, if center line is your eye. So how do we do it? Like the center line is your eye. So I'll just like take it color and once again fill some color here, color fill object. So I'll mark those areas so you'll understand it better and it will be easy for you to understand. RGB. So halfway you have your eyes. Then this half, this below base half, this half, sorry, this half ये नोज एंड्स हेयर, नोज फिनिशेस हेयर, देन अगेन हाफ योर लिप्स फिनिशेस लाइक स्लाइटली अप, लिप्स फिनिशेस एंड देन योर चिन. सो हाफ अगेन हाफ अगेन हाफ. दिस इज बेसिक फंडामेंटल्स एंड दिस इज समथिंग यू शुड नो. एंड सिमिलरली दिस इज एंड दिस इज, सॉरी दिस इज राइट. सो योर ईयर स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम हेयर एंड एंड्स हेयर लाइक बेसिकली दिस एरिया. So this is basic proportions of human anatomy, and this is something you should know and understand. This is how it works. Anything like, yes, for human, humanoid character, or maybe superhuman, or maybe you're some dwarf, or maybe some other characters. Yes, we exaggerate and modify these proportions, but basic fundamentals are this. Initially blocking time, we'll use this and then modify it. Poly paint. Okay. BCB clay buildup again. So this is my eye cavity. I have created the eye cavity, and after this, I have my forehead is here. So my forehead is here. So I just mark those areas. This is my temporal bone. And this part is way too round. So we have the temporal cavity here just above our ear, right? So if you see skull, there's a cavity. See the side cavity? This is your temporal cavity and this is your temporal bone. The eyebrow area is basically this cavity also we have to keep in our mind. So this goes slightly inside like this. Go slightly inside, slightly flat. So I can make it slightly flat and make it soft. And this is, anyways, we're going to fill all these areas. So initially it looks like this, and this part is almost straight. Almost straight. So BMB, your chin and all, it's not inside. It's like this, almost straight. So once you pull it outside, you see there is a space and distance you can see clearly. So most of the time, like people who are new to this thing, character modeling and all, they miss this space, this gap. This is very important. This is small things will play a huge role in your final output. So push the chin slightly outside. Now this nose. So how it works, BCB. So like understand the like this, your skull, you have this and then you have your nose bridge and this thing connects to your cheekbones. Cheekbones are slightly prominent. Female, it's bit stronger. Males, it's slightly softer. And you have this cavity here, nose cavity. So that means it nose will grow like this. So I'll just fill this. So you can see there's a depression very easily. If you follow the basic fundamentals, it will be super easy to create. Too broad. This bone follows like this. It creates this socket, eye socket, basically. Dynamesh it, soft and everything. And now your forehead, this is for men's, it's slightly angular, slightly broad and angular. And this part goes like this, subtle depression, very subtle depression. And this thing blends into this. Now, after this, this goes inside, because this part you don't have bone. You have that denture inside, right? And this denture comes outside. It's a round shape. That lips, you remember, initially we created. So that shape we have to create here, the basic denture. So teeth are slightly outside, very slightly. It's like become a little stronger. So I'll reduce it. And nose also, make it. And nose and all is outside the straight line. And then fill in, connect to your cheekbone. So first create the cavity, then fill in the gaps. Now we have this denture area. So before this denture, we have nose and we have this cheekbone and this like cheeks. So this cheek muscle connects here and it connects to your jaw. So that this, it creates this line that we have. And now we have jaw. The jaw is slightly broad. So it's halfway, almost halfway, because we have ear here. So almost halfway here and straight line. Broaden it up. And it's a little rounded, so I'll make it a little broad and wide. Chin is round. And this gap, it creates a triangle here. This is the basically muscles to control your jaw, expressions and all these things. There's one more muscle that goes back. Check it from all the angles, all the sides. If you don't want to smooth it, that's also fine. Initial blocking time, that is that works perfectly. Now here I see my basic structure is coming together. So BDS. This part, push it slightly inside. Smoothed it, and now I feel my jaw is slightly very narrow. It's BMB, move brush. So what I'll do, I'll broaden my jaw and chin and push this slightly inside, backside, not the front cheekbone, the jaw joint. Make it little angular. This I can push, pull up and down. So you can see it's coming together. Now it looks like a human head. BDS, damn standard. Half of this thing, lips. The lips, this end, usually it goes almost halfway of your eye. So that's how you measure it, like where to create, how to create. That's how you measure it. But there are like some like people are there, they have different proportions. So usually this is like a standard. Lips. Then, after creating this, push this thing inside. That side muscles, if you remember. Now, lip shape, I can see its base lips is coming slightly outside. So I have to push it inside. So control, mask it. BCB. So masking is a very crucial part of ZBrush. If you master this, it will become very easy for you to control and create any kind of shape. But everything depends upon this only, like how you mask it, how you control it. It should go inside those two spherical shapes, BDS. Inside, I can invert it, control click outside. You can see this goes inside automatically. Now some few basic details, BCB. This muscle, look, it's slightly prominent and blended. Now the side have slightly bulge. Basically connects here. BDS is subtle depression, just edge of your lips. Very little minor depression. Those things you can do later also. Now nose. PCB. Nostrils you have to create. BTS, damn standard. Dynamesh. Dynamesh again. Define the shapes. Soften it. Smooth transition. Dynamesh. BCB clay build up. Now I feel nose is like way too slant, so I have to make it little stronger and pull it slightly outside. Much better. And connect the sides. Basic structure. Now, few things I have to fix. B and B. Width of this thickness, and this thing I can make it slightly less angular. Now I need ears, so ears, so we can just simply input this ear, otherwise it will unnecessarily take a long time. Between nose and eyes, here center of your skull, slightly backside, starts at the center. Move it slightly back somewhere here, slightly back, little smaller, and angles have to match. Push it inside. Those things doesn't matter. Dynamesh. Slightly big, so I have to reduce it slightly. Slightly down. dynamesh. Now it's part of this Moodle only. Now eyes, you can see I haven't created the eyes, so without eyes it looks really odd. Save it. Append a sphere 90 degree, scale it down, like outside you can bring it and scale it down. So eyes shape is round. It's always round, always, no matter what. Like if you're creating a creature, character, whatever, you create humanoid, human, alien, eyes will be always round. So roughly one eyeball, another eyeball, and another eyeball. So three eyeballs basically, this eye to this eye. So center you have one eyeball gap, and then you have another eyeball. So three eyeballs. So visually you see that proportion and then place it. So it kind of looks fine. I can symmetry this. The symmetry I can do later also. So let's create the eye like socket and eye socket and your this thing. What you call it, eyelid and all. So here I can see I need to create my eyelid. An eyelid needs to have that fold, very clear, crisp fold. So slightly precise, yes. So eyelid I need to create. So what I'll do, I'll just simply Control Shift D, scale it slightly, and go to trim rectangular, Control Shift, delete half eye. Half eye is gone. And rotate it. We got the eyelid. See, it's very simple. Control Shift D. Base eyelid also done. And these two are two separate meshes in completely. So it becomes super, super easy to control it. BMV. Make sure it never penetrates, never intersect with your eyeball. Eyeball always round. The thickness and everything we should be exactly same. Almost same level, and the corners are slightly overlapped like this. So you can see the moment I place the eye, it looks better. And let's see some eye shape. Make sure the thickness throughout same. Slightly or like difference will be okay, but try to maintain thickness throughout. Slightly more like a structured. So basic shape, once you create this, just merge them together, merge down. and mirrored. Subtool master, mirror. Basic shape, and this one I need to merge with my head. So this line is very important. It should be visible. It can be less or more. Like suppose I want to create this, like this is like, I can see this fold is very prominently visible. So if I want to reduce it, I can definitely add some volume here down and reduce it. Add slightly volume. So this end of eye, we have more bulge. And gradually it blends into this. Dynamesh and then soften it. Can see it looks like I fold that I like top part. And you can see this clear difference. And now we see this circle. You can see this is basically circle eyeball. Then you have a, this is a circular shape, and from the eye end of eyebrow start, this is again a circular shape. So it creates the eye pocket. So it depends again person to person. Some people have very strong eye pockets. Some people have very subtle eye pockets. It grows with age. Older you are, this eye pocket will be stronger. Younger you are, it will be very subtle and almost same level, smooth. So let's merge this down. Dynamesh it. Dynameshed. Now, you see, basic eye and everything is kind of ready. So basic eye, the lips, gums, and other stuff. Now sides and all these things I need to fill. So I defined my cheekbones. Sorry. So now I'll fill those muscles. Previously I was defining the bone structure. Now I'm adding those muscle structure. Let's blend into a skull. This can be a little soft also. Right now it's pretty strong. You have this gap, this clear difference of surface, and then this slight depression, and then fill this area. And this area is also slightly bulky. You can see lips should go slightly inside. Like inside. This is my bad. BCB clay build up soft. Very subtle and subtle difference. Now we have a neck and all. So so here it's a basic human proportion. So if I try to match with the reference, few things I have to modify. So here I can see my eyebrow, this temporal bone is very strong. Make it prominent. Nose is slightly broad. Slightly broad. This connection is very prominently visible. Now my cheekbones are a bit higher. And this particular character, jaw is slightly longer and broader. Lower lips are slightly big. Move brush. Slightly elongated. Okay, it's way too broad. Slightly put inside. So forehead is slightly bigger than this. Basic shapes, PCB, labeled up. Slightly inside. little straight. Okay, basic structure is fine. Now, neck and all these things need to block out. So because we are blocking it out, so we're not adding details. So blocking wise looks kind of fine. And maybe slightly to increase the scale from the back side. Ear have a lot of like, what do you call it, like a structure, nicely structured. Basic ear. Jaw can be slightly, lips can move slightly up. Too much. Add it later. So basic structure is fine. Now I have to add shoulder, torso, and other stuff. So for that, what I'll do is I'll append on the sphere. Move brush, which is symmetry. Place it slightly angled forward. B and V, move brush. DCP and dynamize this also. Now, those muscles that connects neck and shoulder, it start exactly from the behind your eye ears and goes here till your collarbone. The more muscular you are, your neck will be broader, neck and shoulder will be broader. If you are lean, neck will be thinner. Adam's apple. Now you have connecting point here also with the shoulder. Depression for your spine, and then you have two more muscles connects your neck and shoulder. Still, I feel my neck is a bit thinner because neck is usually slightly broader than this. BMV. Slightly broader than this. Basic neck. Okay, let's see. Collarbone. Before adding anything, I just create the cavity. My shoulders basically starts from here. Collarbone. So let's block out basic stuff. Chest. So now I'll append one more sphere. Here, center. Like all deltoid. Yeah, slightly here, and then mirror this thing. Eyes, just move it up. Now I'll just merge them so that I can create this thing very easily. Merge down, and dynamesh it. Everything is dynamesh. Labeled up, so it will become easy for me to control now. Okay. First, create the cavity, blend it, and then shoulder. Just deltoid. Deltoid have three major parts for one muscle that start from the shoulder, wherever it ends from there. So I feel shoulder is slightly narrow. So B and B, I want to make it a little wider. And I feel my character, overall character is slightly like, what do you call it? Small, like, big, because the brush size is 1,000. It's like this much. It should be like bigger than this. So what I'll do is I just simply merge them together and scale it down. Yeah, it's pretty big now. That I can separate later also. So it's as of now, let's keep it like this. So let me see. Slightly longer neck. Slightly down. Okay, tree build up. So I feel dynamic is way too high. I should reduce it. Maybe less. So shift F. Now I have to create those shapes. Back muscle have to create BDS. So first draw the line for spine. It's a straight line. It's very strong. So have to reduce intensity. One. That's fine. Dynamesh. Dynamesh. Oh, it's way too low. Okay. that I need to separate first, hide the eye, split hidden, separated, and I feed. Why dynamic is so weirdly working? Very low. Yeah, this is fine. It's like to reduce it. Okay. This muscle starts from here and goes till here. Muscles, all the back muscles. Basic muscle structure. Sides, I need to enhance. BMP. Now, proportions and volume. And our abs are usually slightly outside like this. Like to small, so we elongate it. BDS time standard. Now let me define few things. This is what I personally prefer. Like when I create this, I use DAM standard. So intensity is very low. I just draw those lines to make it look like okay, like outline. Chest BCB. This part goes slightly inside, slight depression here. After adding this, you have to add, blend it. Then you have rib cage. One, and it's like alternative. And every alternative, you have to add a block here that goes inside. And this rib cage, this muscle. Is very prominent, that goes back just under your shoulder blade. And this is still just blocking, it's like a lot of stuff I have to fix still. I want to create hands. So just simply Dynamesh BCP. So now I have my deltoid, define deltoid and biceps. Triceps. Your elbow. slightly bent curve PCB. So proportion wise, your elbow, like your elbow starts and it should wherever your navel is. So that means I have to elongate the hand slightly. It's very small.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, we stop, sir, here.
Okay, no problem. I'll stop it here. So, like, it's still blocking, so it will take little time. So, we'll block out everything nicely. And you can see, like, it's not very difficult if you know the proportional scale and always have a reference. Like, whenever you're working on it, always have a reference open and so that you can cross check always. So that will make your life way easier. So refer to that and start creating things, and then slowly initially do not add details, just block out the basic volume, out the volume, then we'll move to once the basic blocking is done, then we move to some detailing.
Okay.
Detailing is last stage. Detailing is super easy last stage. So before that, getting the shape correct is everything.
Okay. Shape, it will take too much time to understand.
Yes, shape takes time, because if a shape is correct, everything becomes super easy. If a shape is not correct, it takes a lot time. So let's name it a blocking. So work on the shape. Detailing won't take much time. Detailing is super easy, but blocking is important, very important. So make sure always have a reference and follow the reference and try to match the volume. Try to match the volume. It's still in here, I can clearly see my hands, forearm is way too wide. It cannot be. It's not human proportion. Then underarms are a little narrow. I have to broaden that section. So everything have to balance slowly. And chest, I can see it looks like a straight line. It cannot be like this. Neck is way too long yet. So I have to balance all this thing. Shoulder, the back muscles, it looks fine, but it's way too much of deformation. Like way too much is going inside and outside. It should be a little subtle. So those things, work on it and fix everything. Okay, I'll do it slowly, no problem. So after try this thing out, if you face any problem, anything, so we'll see what can be done. And it's only practice, matter of practice, okay? I'll send you the video and everything.
Okay.
Yeah. So just practice this thing. I'll practice. Okay. This is very important. Have a reference. Always have a reference. Do not do anything from memory. Yes. Memory is good, but thing is, if you have something for reference, it becomes easy. So always you have something to refer to, so you can do it very easily. So make sure poker have a reference, or you can find multiple references. That is also fine, but follow front pose, back pose, your side, all three pose you should have as a reference. That book have all the references. You can use that book. That will work beautifully.
Okay, sir.
Okay, then. Practice this and we'll see. Okay.
Yeah. Saturday will 3 o'clock, sir.
Saturday at 3 o'clock. We'll do it.
Okay.
Okay.